Right, so our last speaker is Harish. You've got 3 minutes in your head, right? It's 2 o'clock. Sure? Okay, 3, 2, 1, go.
I've seen Star Wars. One of the major attractions of these movies is the use of colorful lightings called lasers, which are not science fiction anymore. A laser is an intense beam of light. Unlike sunlight, which is made of several rainbow colors, a laser is made of a single rainbow color. And unlike your fluorescent lamp, which emits light in all directions, a laser is highly directional. Many lasers, ranging from small to medium powers, are used extensively in our daily lives, like in a DVD player or in a laser eye surgery. Hi, I'm Harish from Optoelectronic Research Center, and I'm interested in high-power lasers. Nowadays, there are some high-power lasers being used in industries which can cut through metal sheets. And recently, there are some demonstrations of lasers so powerful that they can strike down a missile. My research is to build high-power lasers using long, hair-thin glass rods called optical fibers. An optical fiber is ideally suited to build a high-power laser as it can lose heat very quickly and is highly efficient compared to other methods of laser generation. Even though an optical fiber is very well suited, there are certain processes occurring within the fiber at very high laser powers which limit the amount of power it can generate. One of the most prominent and foremost effects when you are trying to raise the power level of a strictly single color laser in an optical fiber is the generation of density fluctuations similar to sound waves. These sound waves, which travel along the length of these glass rods, act in a way as to oppose the growth of the laser power. My thesis focuses on finding ways of suppressing the sound waves and getting out as much power as possible. Although very high powers can be reached with a fiber optic laser, there's a certain upper limit. So what do you do to get still higher powers? As many of you might have rightly guessed, we can combine the output of several hundreds of these lasers such that the powers add up to give a highly intense super laser. It's widely believed among the laser community that one of the potential applications of such an extremely powerful laser is to achieve nuclear fusion, a clean, renewable, alternate source of energy which can replace fossil fuels and in turn reduce carbon emissions into the atmosphere. Though we are not there yet, my research will form an important building block of such future technologies. Thanks for listening.